tens of thousands killed. That is the latest estimate from the Red Cross following this week's devastating earthquake in Haiti. Putting the facts in focus tonight, a spokesman for the Red Cross says between 45 and 50,000 people have been killed. Today, the president announced a massive relief effort with thousands of U.S. troops headed to Haiti, along with $100 million in relief funds. And because of all the relief flights arriving in Haiti, U.S. officials have halted all civilian flights to Haiti at the request of the Haitian government. Here in Maine, Governor Baldacci addressed the situation, pledging the state's full support for the relief effort.
Right now, they're telling us that they need to have financial resources, dedicate those to the American Red Cross and to USAID efforts. At the same time, I think Maine people, if they want to be active and helpful, is to donate blood to the American Red Cross, as you heard about the need here in Maine.
We also learned this afternoon that two Colby College students in Haiti at the time of the earthquake have been located. Colby officials say seniors Yannicka Faustin of New York City and Jessica Frick, who is from Maine, are both doing fine. That's good news. Meantime, News 8 has heard from several Mainers with plans to travel to the earthquake zone to help in the massive relief effort. Steve Minich joins us now with continuing coverage. Steve?
Well, Tori, these are both individuals and members of organizations with extremely close ties to Haiti. Right now, they are scrambling to make sure they can deliver as much as possible, as quickly as possible.
We have a 40-ton crane on board.
Greg Brooks, Gorham-based company Subsea Research, owns this 200-foot cargo ship, which is currently sitting idle in Boston. By next week, he hopes to fill it with more than 1 million pounds of survival supplies and sail it south to Haiti.
I'm worried about what's going on there, and it is close to my heart, and I want to go back. I do have resources.
5 years ago, following the Hurricane Katrina disaster, Brooks spearheaded a similar relief effort using those same resources to deliver aid to victims in Louisiana.
So we were there, and we helped hundreds and hundreds of people. And if we can do that in Haiti, that's going to, well, it's just the right thing to do.
We're not able to get through the cell phone system.
In Falmouth, the outreach organization Convit Sante remains virtually cut off from its staff and Haitian partners who work in hospitals primarily north of the earthquake zone.
I don't know how this is going to evolve. It's clearly unprecedented in Haiti, the level of calamity.
The organization has spent nearly a decade working to improve Haiti's healthcare system. Executive Director Nate Nickerson will head there on Saturday.
I want to come down with some monies that we can work with them and not just say, here, we're here to give you moral support.
These Mainers will spend the next days soliciting as much help as they can, motivated simply, they say, by their passion for the Haitian people.
It's the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere, but the people are the nicest people in the Western Hemisphere, as far as I'm concerned.
If you would like to donate to either of those relief efforts, we have links to both websites. Just go to the As Seen On section of WMTW.com. In the newsroom, Steve Minich, News 8.